Hello, hello everyone. This is El St. John, along with me and my son Ben.
Hello and welcome, sexy Rose Soul Creators.
Exactly, yes. You know, we just came from sitting down with Gilbert and Christina. And Gilbert had told me his story, I would say 3 months ago. He started talking to us over our over the Skype. Was it Skype or was it one of those?
Yeah.
Instago.
What, one of those video calls?
Video calls. We had a video call with him a number of times.
Right.
And just, I would say, less than a mile from where we're at, we met with him. He asked to see if we could meet and talk. And sure, living here in Southern California, we can do that, no problem.
Right.
He was in a very tough, rough, difficult state of being at the time when we first saw him, remember?
Right.
It was before Christmas, I think it was.
Roughly around
the first
that time.
And then after that, it was just over Skype or video calls.
Right.
And his girlfriend had just dumped him. Christina had just ruthlessly said goodbye to him, had blocked him from every single social media app or platform, and did not want to know anything about him. He was just totally, totally casted away.
Right. We do apologize for all the children around here.
We have a little kids back there yelling and screaming.
Yeah.
We're out in the open. What can we do, right? But enjoy nature, and that is a part of nature.
Yes.
Anyways, I remember he was in a very difficult, difficult moment of his life. And little by little, it took him some time to pick up, as it does to all of us.
Right.
And this is a process that we all must go through.
Right.
Okay, but the sooner we shake it off, the better. As right. I've been telling everyone in all of our videos, and as I told Gilbert months ago, you must shake off of it as soon as you can.
Exactly.
So that if you really want this woman back, you can become that same manifester and fun person that she once stepped into his life.
Right.
So, you know, he just couldn't find the edge. Couldn't find it. You know, he just was very down, very depressed. Understandable. Okay.
Right.
Until I gave him the exercise of writing your own story.
Right.
I remember that was the one of the tips I talked to him about. We talked to him about now then.
Yes.
And I told him, you know, start the writing your story exercise, which will help you regain the peace that you so much need.
Exactly.
And will help you look towards the future. And will help you heal the present. Okay? He did it. It took him, I would say, about a week to even start.
Right.
Because he was just so, so down about it.
Right.
And just very down. But it eventually, you know, it started to work for him. He
exactly.
eventually started to work on it. He started to really, you know, follow the steps. And before we knew it, he snapped out of it.
There you go.
He snapped out of that depression. This doesn't mean that he forgot about Christina. Christina was still very much in his heart, in his thoughts, in his daily life.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And from there, from talking to Christina, I mean from talking to him, one day Christina calls him.
Right.
Okay? Remember, he couldn't get a hold of her because she had blocked him completely. She had blocked him and she didn't want to know anything about him. In fact, she even moved. She wasn't living in the same apartment or anything like that. She moved, okay? She didn't want to know anything about him. One day, okay, as we said, she contacts him at his job, okay? Not even to his personal phone, which remained the same, okay? Which means if you do a no contact, your loved one is not going to forget about you.
No.
On the contrary, you're still very much in their mind. Exactly. You're still very much in their thoughts. You don't forget one person, you know, from one day to another.
No.
You don't forget a relationship from one day to another.
No.
It comes to you.
It does.
It comes to you. Okay, that's why time, stepping back is such an important step.
It is.
Okay, when there's something going on.
Exactly.
Not exactly the way you want it to go.
Right.
Okay, so she contacts him and she asks him to, for some of his time, you know, so that they can both talk. By then, Gilbert was in a position of power, okay? He had been going to the gym. He had been eating the best that he could. He was on salads and grilled chicken. I remember him telling me that. And grilled salmon as well. That was another favorite of his. And I would talk to him. By then, I would talk to Gilbert once a week. And he would give me an update of what he was doing. And, you know, I would listen to him. And we would discuss what the next plan was. And he was just doing really good. Did even better, honestly, because he was expecting her phone call. But it just wouldn't come soon enough. It took several months.
Right.
Almost 4 months. For Gilbert to get any news from Christina.
Right.
Okay, they meet at a place nearby the Pacific Ocean, precisely very close to where we're at.
Yes.
And she's asking for forgiveness. She's by then they both have healed. She had given him the boot, but she was still hurt, okay? The breaking up was still very hurtful for the two of them. He had been under our care, okay? so he was doing a lot better. He was,
yes.
You know, he had been doing a lot of the positive exercises that we give, and you know, he had been walking. And instead of just running or falling or slipping or
right.
he had started to walk on firm soil. And she, even though she had been the one who said goodbye to that relationship to break it off,
right.
You know, she was not at her best. But okay, you know, the day came, they both talked. She asked for his apology and got it. By then, Gilbert was at a very, like we said, in a powerful state.
Right.
He no longer felt that hurt. Of course, he loved her. He remembered the good old days. And yes, you know, there was nothing that was going to rip him away from that day that he was given the boot.
Right.
But they remained in contact ever since. Okay, and just a few days ago, by then, Gilbert and still, you know, remains in contact with us.
Right.
He would give me a 10-minute update every week, because by now he's, you know, was very strong and going on with his life.
Right.
And he tells me, can we meet in the same place that we met around December? I told him, well, let me ask Ben if he's got time as well, so we can, you know, the three of us could have a cup of coffee.
Right.
And he said, the four of us. Ooh.
Oh, wow.
Okay. In the beginning, they told me the story when she asked him, can we come back? Can we be girlfriend and boyfriend again? He said no. So the coin had been turned around. Okay? We met and they were telling me the story. He didn't want to go back to her anymore. He loved her, but didn't want to go through any pain related with her again. Wow. So it took Christina a while to convince him that she should not do that anymore. She should not give this man that she loved the boot. Of course, there was reasons why she did that, but they were both able to iron them out. Okay, that is why, my friends, if you're in this situation, it can happen to you.
Yes, it can.
Get yourself a good support system.
Exactly, because you can't do it all alone.
You sometimes can't do it all alone. You need someone to talk to. You need a good support system, whether it be family, friends, a coach. But yes, it can happen.
It can happen.
It can all be well again. It can all be well again. And all the bad, the sad feelings must be buried in the past.
Yeah.
Must stay in the past.
Exactly.
Because they're not going to help you bringing them to the now, to the present, and much less to the future.
Exactly.
Okay, so I just wanted to give you guys this positive story.
Yes.
Share with you guys this positive story that if you're in a situation where your loved one gave you the boot, and you're in a desperate state of being because you don't know what to do, you believe that you've lost that person,
right.
You know, it can all turn around. It can all be possible. All is possible for you to manifest your loved one back if you do it the right way.
Exactly.
If you do it the right way and you want to do it the right way to maintain that loved one right next to you and you next to your loved one.
Yes.
Okay, so from a sweet spot here in sunny Southern California, all is possible. Don't you forget that.
And keep those vibrations infinitely strong.
Exactly. Subscribe to our channel. Catch us on Facebook as well. Visit our website.
Yes. www.roseforasoul.com.
Yes. Namaste.
Namaste.